Yeah, I have a friend of mine who says, if you don't second, like, if you feel confident all the time as an entrepreneur, then you're probably a narcissist. So I found that so freeing. So, like, I'm sharing that with you. Hopefully that will make you feel better. Yeah.
Yeah, that does make me feel better.
Yeah. All right. One last thing that I want to ask you. If someone watching today or listening was thinking, I want to use my business as a force of good, I want to make an impact with my business, what would your advice be to them? Would there be any things that you would avoid now that you've gone through it and you've been at it for many years? Really tips that you want to share with them?
I think at the beginning, I didn't have a clear idea. And again, I would say this is in some ways is a positive, but I didn't have a clear idea. I knew that beyond the food truck side. I think I saw it as perhaps a project, maybe a 2 to 5 year project. But I didn't, again, this might be linked to that, the villain kind of question that you just asked. I didn't really give it space to say, well, what about if it was, what about if this is a business that thrives? What about if this is a 20 year plan? What would the business look like? Or what would it be? And I don't know that I always have the strategic thinking. I can see, but I don't always see the steps in between. And I'd say know what your strength is. So if you're more of a visionary, like you said you're a strategist, get alongside a strategist and say, right, you know, give me a day of your time. If you need to pay them, find a way of paying them, whatever it is, or it's a friend and it's, you know, whatever, however you work it. But somebody, I wish I'd have had somebody at that stage to help me bottom out a little the steps. But I don't know if I'd have listened to them if they'd have said, hey, do you need a strategy? You know, I don't know if my ego would have just been like, no, I don't. I'm fine.
I can do it myself.
Yeah, I can do it myself, but I don't want to be held back. And I didn't, you know, every time somebody did ask a question like that, I was aware of that. I felt a time pressure, like I had to do it now. And maybe that would be my advice. I don't think there is a time. I think the world tells you and the social media, it's all about time and we're running out of time. And yes, in some ways you could say that, but in terms of the bigger picture of life and how it works, but there's always, you know, some of the most famous artists became famous, Van Gogh, whatever, you know, 80 and, people do stuff all through their life. I think this notion that there is this time pressure or that if we're not helping somebody now, then, you know, they won't be helped. Well, it's like making ourselves the God figure. And actually, we just need to do the thing. The better thing would be to do it really well when we do it. And even if that's, even if you end up kind of having an impact on less people, but it's a more holistic impact, an impact that will last rather than something rushed. And I didn't have that. You know, I think I was really, because I felt the kind of inertia of starting and there were so many hurdles, but I think to have just broken it down and known, you know, it's fine, give yourself 5 years to get to this next step. That would have actually been really freeing. And now I find that that's really helpful to say, no, we don't need to launch another product or an event in 3 months. Let's do it this time next year and let's plan it. And let's, you know, if it's too much, don't do it. You know, sometimes you feel the financial pressure or the whatever pressure, but just the reputational pressure or the, you know, the ego pressure, you know, that, but I've got to be producing or I've got to be efficient. And, but I think that's something that I would change. And I try now if I see myself going into it, if I see us as a business, just falling into something unplanned, then trying to pull back and say, look, is there anything we can change? Can we change a goalpost here? Can we push something back? And I know it's not the cool thing to do, but like letting people down, maybe saying, hey, I can't do this. But and invaluable in starting a business, whether it's for good or not, but is having a mentor. And I don't currently have one. Very sadly, my mentor died at the beginning of COVID, not of COVID, but yeah, he passed away.
Sorry. And
just very suddenly, thank you. Yes, yeah, it's so gutting. I just think almost on a weekly basis, I'm like, Faisal, what would you do? And he was the thing that was amazing was that he was so different from me. So I had these options of having somebody that was sort of more similar and who I was so inspired by. And he was speaking internationally and he said, don't worry, we can have Zoom calls from, I'll be in Geneva and you'll be there. And I thought, my God, you know, I was kind of blown away by the, I don't know, flashiness of it. But also he was the way, what he was speaking on in his heart, I connected with. But this other guy, Faisal, he had really amazing templates. He'd come from a management consultant background, but yeah, I felt we were really different. But the way that we worked together and the way he brought clarity to my kind of vision and thinking and actually strategy. He was a real strategist. He would just say, what's the next step? Okay, well, you need this done by next week when we meet. Or it just somebody giving me deadlines was really helpful, because all I could see is all the deadlines. And how do you know? Everything to me is a deadline. You know, all my to-do list is a deadline. It's like, when is the deadline? It's now. You know, I make it all now. And he would filter it out and push it into different boxes and places. And I guess help me see the wood for the trees. And
that's, you know, real so good. So good. Yeah. Great mentors are such a gift.